I'm at Chris's Billiards in Chicago, Illinois. We're at the fifth stop of the 1998 Carom Corner Tour, and we have a very exciting match ahead of us. Sitting in with me to do the commentary is the number one ranked player in the world. It's a thrill to have Mr. Dick Jaspers sitting in with me, and he will help explain what's going on because half the time I don't have a clue.
I try my best.
Say hello to everybody.
Hello, everybody.
Hello. All right, in the match that we have in front of us is two great players, Mr. Sang Lee and Mr. Semih Sayginer, and they are both seeded players going to 50 points, and it should prove to be a really great match. And they're warming up right now. Sang is warming up, and when he is done, they'll make the announcements, they'll lag, and we'll get on with the game. Now, this particular tournament originally started with 36 players in the qualification round, out of which 10 players advanced to the finals, plus there are four seeded players. Mr. Jaspers is one, Sang Lee, Semih Sayginer, and Mr. Raymond Kuhlemans were all seeded, so we have a round robin of 14 players, and we're about halfway through it now. This is one of the very important matches of the tournament. Now, Mr. Jaspers just completed a game, a great game with Raymond Kuhlemans, where he defeated him, making 50 points in 18 innings?
18 innings.
Great game, great game. Of course, he had a better game that we didn't catch on tape. That one we got on tape. We missed the one where you did 50 points in 13 innings.
Yes.
That would have been nice to catch that one, but happened to be on the wrong table.
It was a very good game, yes.
Yes. It's just incredible to watch you play. I just can't imagine how you could hit the ball so good so often.
I had not so many difficult positions in the game. I can concentrate myself.
It's got to take a lot of concentration, a lot of practice, and a lot of hard work. I know it just doesn't come automatically.
I think I'm a hard worker in the game, and I try to play everything perfectly.
Hmm. Well, you come pretty darn close. I think Mr. Kuhlemans, what did he get that game? He really held him down. What did he have? I don't think he got to 20, did he?
He got 22 points.
22 points. That's amazing.
Yeah. But still, he's always dangerous. Still.
Oh, yeah, because he had a game with Francis, what's his name? Proton.
Yes.
Where I think Mr. Proton had him 21-3 or something, 24-3, and Mr. Kuhlemans came back and actually won the match.
Yes,
and he was giving him 7-point spot, too.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. I mean, I have great respect for him.
Without question.
For his mentality and so much experience with everything.
29 world titles? that's more than half the players are alive. 29 titles.
Yeah. Okay, you must also see how the time was. But okay, 29 world titles is perfect.
Yeah.
It's fantastic.
It's
and he made Bolivia's into a fantastic game.
He is really responsible for billiards. In this country, it's not as big as we would like it. We're trying to grow it, but throughout the world, billiards is a major sport, and I guess if there's any one person to be given most of the credit, it's Mr. Kuhlemans, because he's just helped the game tremendously over the years.
Yes, absolutely. He was also my great example.
And you and many other people, I imagine.
And I didn't have many lessons. I didn't got many lessons at Tweekerson, but I watched many games from Kuhlemans. Also other players, but Well, he, I see him as a professor.
Yes.
Of precursor.
He is a doctor of the game, no question about it.
And he inspires me a lot.
I think he inspires a lot of people. When people see him play and you, I mean, just to watch you play and the rest of these great players, Sangley, Sammy, Frederick, it really gives you something to look for. I mean, the way the average player like myself plays, it's such a different world than what you play, and it allows you to at least know where you should be going. Whether or not we get there, that's another story, but at least you have something to shoot for. Let's see, Sammy is doing his warm-ups now. I believe we're running the tape now of Sammy warming up. Saturday. There's quite a large turnout in here. There's a lot of people for your game. The place was packed. You couldn't even find standing room in here during your game. I had to stand up on the scaffold where we have the camera just to see what was going on.
Yeah, that was a very good atmosphere. There was interest from people. Mm. And yeah, we feel good.
Yeah, that was nice, especially when you play well. But I tell you, this room, I don't know about in Europe, but in a lot of the rooms, the tables are close together. This room, the way they have the table set up, there's a lot of room, and the tables are playing very, very nice. It's really, really nice. There should be, I see Charlie Brown, the tournament director. He's getting about ready to make the announcements, and then we'll proceed with the game. As soon as when the game's actually about to begin, Don Sperber, who is one of the contestants who did not qualify for the finals, he's going to take my headset and sit in with you and chat with you during the game. I know you know Don.
Yes, I know.
Yeah. So you could help educate him as you educate the rest of us on the tape.
All we have two totally different players, and not so easy ones.
No, they're very different in style, and they both are remarkable players. I mean, Sammy with his, he has that style and that stroke, and Sangley has that unusual flair and in his intuitiveness. So anything can happen here.
Yes, please, orange juice. Orange juice, please. Yes.
No, nothing to me. That was Don Sperber taking our order. Okay, looks like Dave Levine, another one of the contestants that was in the preliminaries, is going to referee the match. And I believe Judy Manis is going to be the scorekeeper. You've played with both of these gentlemen many times, Sammy and Sangley. Give us your insight as to what we can expect. If there's any way to do that, I don't know.
Well, it's very difficult to work.
Yeah, it's hard to predict.
You must see what the positions are, how the positions could be, can be, and I think Semih is not in a good shape so far. So let's hope he's very inspired to come back.
Yes. He needs a good game. He needs
a good game. Yes.
He's had some problems in the games. He's had some bad breaks and tough getting started. I guess it happens to even the greatest players every once in a while.
But I think there was a lot of public, and it inspires everybody to to do everything to do it.
Plus, they play good together. They played before, and I know sometimes depends who you're playing. It brings out your game. I hope they both play well.
Yes, it's always nice to see good players.
Yes.
It depends sometimes on the positions and what can you do. Sometimes the game is so difficult. Sometimes.
Yeah, I had seen in the preliminaries, Frederick Coudron, who played the qualifiers, he went through everybody like a buzzsaw. I mean, just every game was 15, 20 minutes. They were only 25-point games, but they really went fast.
Yeah.
And then in the finals, he had problems in a couple of games. It was just,
yeah.
I mean, he was playing so good, and then just a few games, he had trouble.
It's a very long tournament. I think we're not used to this kind of tournament.
Yeah, you do mostly single elimination, correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's a very good practice.
Yeah, this is a lot of games.
Yeah,
a lot of games.
And,
so there's endurance involved. Okay, let's listen to the announcements. So I'm going to turn up the volume on it.
$150,000 Green Cushion Billiard Tournament. I'd like to introduce the players. Players on table number 28. Currently, number one ranked player in Belgium, Mr. Francis Fortcombe. With Mr. Fortcombe, currently number three ranked player in the world and winner of two World Cup tournaments, recently winning Bogota, Colombia. Please give a nice hand for Mr. Frederic Coudron. On table number 26, playing in his first three-cushion tournament, reaching the finals, from Chicago, Mr. Peter Rincon. Playing with Mr. Rincon, from New York, USA, Mr. Min Jae Pak. On table number 24, playing in all of these three cushion tournaments that Karen Corner has sponsored and reaching the final from New York, Mr. Michael Kang. With Mr. Kang, another gentleman who's played in all of our tournaments and has reached the final and done exceedingly well, Mr. Mazin Shooni, Detroit, Mississippi, USA. On table number 25, we're playing the final match, the championship match for the Frank-Spanish finals, which is the top third place finishers play a single elimination. These two gentlemen have reached the final match, and they're going to play for the championship of the Frank-Spanish finals. We have Mr. Soon Kim from USA. Pedro Bueno, New York City, USA. On table number 27, we have from Turkey, the artistic billiard grandmaster, Mr. Semih Sayginer. With Mr. Sayginer, also eight-time U.S. national champion and defending national champion, and also 1993 BWA champion, world champion, please welcome from New York City, USA, Mr. Sang Chun Lee. Gentlemen, please begin.
Okay, Mr. Jaspers, I'm going to give my headset to Don Sperber, who you know, and he will come online and he will assist you, or you will assist him in the commentary of this game. So it's been a pleasure, and I look forward to working with you
okay.
again.
Thank you, Tony.
Don,
yep.
Come take this chair over here. See if you can get this headset on over your ponytail.
Hello,
Don.
Fans all over the world. Welcome to the match with Sang Lee and Semih Sayginer. How does this position look to you off the break?
Not so good, I think, because of red ball is so close in the corner. But I think he can make it. He can draw. He can make a door shot from the second to avoid. No, he's not doing it. It's a little bit risky. You never know if you're gonna take the third cushion. So let's see. I think it was possible.
Very difficult to shoot from behind your back, but when you're skinny, you're able to bend over a little bit better than us heavy-set people.
It's a little bit remarkable. He can, singly, he doesn't play left-handed. A little bit remarkable, because most players play left-handed.
In the standings right now, Sang Lee has two losses along with three other players, and Semih Sayginer has, I believe, four losses. So it's a very important game.
I think Sang Lee has the best chances.
Yes.
I think he's playing just a little bit better. So he needs a good game. That's a little bit unlucky. It's a good play. I think it's possible from the red, yes. He can play perfect position now. He put the yellow in the corner. Yes.
When Semih shoots off the yellow ball, in order to keep it in the corner for the people listening to the tape and watching it, how do you hit that ball so that it doesn't travel so far? Use a long stroke, a short stroke?
Well, I think I play a little more sensitive.
Okay.
Maybe I think a little bit more about position. But okay, this is perfectly played. Three balls, a long cushion. It's always, almost always, a good position. Bravo.
Good shot.
Yeah, it's a wonderful stroke.
I think the American players, when we get up and we shoot, we're just happy to make the point, and we really don't have any idea where any of the balls are rolling. And if we're playing position at all, it's probably by luck if we come up soft onto the ball that we score on.
Well, I think you must pay a lot of attention to your stroke with every shot. Sometimes you must not take care of position, just try to make the point. But sometimes it's very important to think about position.
I think most of the Europeans always know where the balls are going.
Well, I don't know. It's very good play. You see where the white ball is coming at. Cannot be better, because he has to take care for a kiss, for his speed. Yes. All nice positions to make. A very difficult, good chance to play position. The red ball is coming back to the long cushion.
If they hit every shot so good, it makes it look so easy that you wonder why it's so difficult when us amateurs step up to the table.
Yeah, well, this is not so difficult, but you must have a high concentration, like always, as always.
Looks like perfect position again.
Yes. But this is not so easy. So I think the best way is play from the red and make a draw shot. Short, long, yes. He plays very softly. I would play it more faster. The second ball is so close to the cushion, it's always a little bit risky to play soft because you have chance that that your cue ball is going to go away from the cushion, to make a curve.
When he played it soft, was he playing to be safe for the next for the other player, or just basically to keep the position?
No, I think Singly likes to play sometimes very smoothly, very soft. It's just personal. You can't think too much about the position, you just try to make it.
What is the score now? I'm not able to see the
7-4, Singly. He would play from the yellow, draw shot, very thin, a lot of English. He's doing something special. I don't understand. I mean it.
Well, it certainly would look good if he'd make a shot like that. It's definitely a crowd pleaser. Yeah. In New York, when he played the tournament Masters in July, he seemed to be changing his style, saying he would play more serious to score, and he didn't play to the crowd with the showboating type shots. And here, seems like he's been playing a lot more serious up until a shot like that. But sometimes they play these shots, it just loosens them up, and from there they break loose and are able to have a good inning.
I think sometimes it's good to be creative, to show a little bit of fantasy. I keep it always very simple. That's why maybe I make many points. But I mean, that was another solution, which was not so bad. I didn't understand why you don't took it at the beginning of the game. It's a little bit risky.
Yes. He had two other choices, no doubt about it.
Yeah. That is good.
Our referee today is Dave Levine, who's one of the better referees. He watches all the shots, he stays out of the way of the players, and the crowd likes him because they're able to watch the game and enjoy it. And unfortunately, Dave Levine needed 1 point to win his match against Jan Carl to continue on to the finals. Instead, he was knocked out, and Chan played in the mini-finals. Most of the local players here in Chicago were overwhelmed to see the play of the European style of play, that they would hit the ball so clean, know where all the balls were traveling around the table, and the high averages, that averaging two and a half, three and a half is just norm for most of the players that came here to play. So we're really getting a treat. I think the man with the best three or four top games is sitting next to me, and I'll have to ask him why he's playing so good. I don't want to jinx him or anything like that.
Well, I think I play now nine or ten games, and it's lovely to play many games on the same tables. You feel each game more, you feel more and more confidence, you know, how to shoot, you know, what is easy, what is difficult. It's not a World Cup tournament where if you lose the first round, you are out.
Oh yeah, the
a little bit less
point games are treacherous. One miscue and you can pack your suitcases and call the airline telling you're on your way down.
Ah, that's bank shot from the red.
No, I think he's going to play off the white. That's his specialty.
Yeah.
He gets one rail, he gets a hook, and he gets two rails, and he hits that ball as good as anybody.
Yeah, that's... He specialized in this, yes. I think it's my weakness to play shots like this.
Well, you're one of the players that you're able to create a simpler shot. I think your batting average is much higher than everybody else's in that type of situation, where you would score over 50%, and no doubt about it, the shot may look nicer when Sangli plays it, and you see the nice curve and it comes around, but at best you can only make 3, maybe 4 out of 10, and that's only my opinion. So all the people listening to me jumping up and down right now, or send me a letter, or send me a donation with your comment to Carom Corner, and we'll put your money to good use to replace me. Something like that.
This is very difficult. Another bank shot. So a lot of bank shots already in the beginning. I think I will do the same. Yes.
I think most of the players of my caliber would hit the first ball and hope for the best.
That's why I don't play these shots much. It's too risky for me. Everything must be perfect.
I mean, this type of shot, when they get up and shoot it, they shoot it with so much confidence, and they hit the ball so perfect, and they don't catch the edge. It's always dead center. It's just amazing the confidence you have to have to get up and look at the same shot over and over again and just feel that it can't be missed mentally, and just hit it. It just goes exactly where you want it to go.
It's a matter of a lot of experience, many games playing. You play really a lot of games throughout the year.
Well, I was glad to see Sammy make this shot in the last couple of games. He's hit a lot of balls, and for whatever reason, they drifted a little, or they came in short, and he kept missing the edges, and he hasn't had his share of good luck on a lot of these little hits just coming by and missing. just beat that kiss. And it's going to pass by. But his leave is excellent.
Excellent. Defensive.
If he would have made it, he'd have natural position to continue, which is really what this game is all about. I have no idea what he's doing here.
Bank shot to the right. Long, long. Maybe it's a short cushion first.
Nope. Back to the old three rail shot.
Bravo.
Bravo. I guess my 40% average is shot. He's shot it twice and made it once, so it's 50-50 right now. We'll have to see what happens the next time when a shot comes up.
I would not think about playing this shot. Yes, a lot of confidence.
I don't think he's very happy with this hit.
Yeah.
Must have been exhausted from the shot before that he just made.
Yeah, you have to. You must try to forget as soon as possible.
Is this going to be twice around?
I think yes, twice around.
Yeah.
Or maybe with the contra.
Maybe reverse the rails.
I think door shot. Yeah.
Oh, backwards, upwards, side down shot. Wow. Well, that's why they call him the crowd pleaser. He can always get up and pop one of them off.
But there was no other way almost. He had to play this shot.
I think it's a big ball, because if you miss real hard, you can come down to the short rail and back up. So
there are two changes really, yes.
This is where you really got to break loose after making a good shot like that, and get the position and put together a strong inning. I think the players also are willing to take a chance and play a shot that's a little more difficult in a 50-point game, whereas in a 15-point game, one mistake could be your ticket home. You're playing in a World Cup, whereas here, 50 points, you miss one or two shots, you could overcome it. What type of shot would he look at here? Would he try to go off the yellow, four rails?
I think
off the red.
From the red, always from the red.
Long rail, long
rail. It would
rail.
Be stupid to play from the yellow. Yes, he can make.
Draw back maybe?
Yes, or maybe, yeah.
He sure has the stroke for it. And it looks like he's
very nice.
Getting in form here.
It's a big advantage from Semi that he has a wonderful stroke with a lot of quality.
Oh yeah.
And it will never leave him alone.
Yeah, nice little hook on that ball.
Bravo.
Little body English with the stick. Ball comes right in on the yellow. Crowd's happy.
And he doesn't take a lot of time for it. It's incredible. He uses his fantasy, he sees a shot, and they just play it. Like it's a common shot.
Oh yeah.
Well, these shots I like to play from the yellow to the short cushion. You have to the shot cushion here below, and then in the corner.
And
one of my favorite shot
buttons. What ball speed do you use for the shot like this? Nice and slow?
Yes, nice and slow, yes.
Seven.
Problem.
That's 7 points.
Yes. I try always to put the yellow ball in the corner. Sometimes I ask too much about myself, because making the shot is so difficult enough.
Nice hit, perfect speed.
Yes.
Well, I'm not sure what he's going to play here. You'll have to help me out. Drawback?
No, I don't. A thin from the yellow. But how do you call that?
Long rail.
Yeah.
I don't know why. I just think he may draw back. I think he likes to get that nice. No, I guess I'm wrong. No, he's.
There was a big hole.
Left hand English, then hit on the yellow. Nice spin, good ball speed. And it's good.
Yeah.
Just caught the outside of the ball.
You must be a little bit lucky with the shot, because you can't control where your cue ball is coming in the corner, and then there was a big hole. It was not a lucky shot, but it's a little bit, don't think too much, just play.
Oh yeah.
You can't control everything.
It's nice to be lucky and be good.
He played it very good, but I mean, when there was such a big hole, it's not so easy. If you miss this shot, you can't say I was unlucky. You have to make the shot.
And he got the red over into the corner, but he didn't get behind the yellow, so he's got a little bit of a problem now.
Well, I think it's possible, but for a draw shot, but just give maximum power.
Even this close to the rail?
Yes.
Oh yeah, he's digging down a little.
I think
like
it's possible, really.
I guess he must have heard us, so he's going to listen to you and play the shot with the drawback.
But you have to go through the ball a lot.
So he's saying...
through the ball, yeah.
Yeah, almost full hit on the yellow, just enough that it goes to the left. So it pulls back.
No, it's not doing it. Thin, long rail, long rail.
Yeah, he's going to go back and forth and drop it in. And if he makes it, the yellow should go up and down. And now he's chasing the red for a known as a cluck. Or in Masters 4, it would be called a chimber. Got an 11, and he's able to continue.
Yeah, this was a lucky shot. But I must say, this is a fantastic run. 11.
Yes.
Many, many beautiful, very difficult shots. I think I must say, from red.
He's going to hit this ball very thin, just move the red a hair, and maybe he played it this way from the back, and just missed.
Bravo.
I'll have to wait for the scorekeeper to put up the points, and we'll tell you what the innings are and what the score is.
17-10.
We'll have to ask the scorekeeper how many innings. How many innings is it so far? Six innings.
One.
And he has 17 points.
Oh. Yeah, that's wonderful.
Well, we won't hold it against him. He's just a little under average of 3. In all all these matches when one player gets up and puts together a couple of good innings and gets a big lead, you can almost sense that the other player is going to come back with a 5 or a 10, or he's going to put up a good scoring inning or two real quick.
Proper. Well, now I would play from the red, but it's very interesting what the red ball is doing.
Yes. Just right by that white ball.
I would never, I think I don't play the solution because it's, you have to hit it so perfectly with the right English. It's a small chance to make it, but I think he has a lot of confidence.
Well, what else, what other shot could he have played on that?
Sorry?
What shot would he have played other than that?
I think round, double round.
Oh, double round the table.
And maybe I hit the red ball very thick or very thin. One of the two possibilities.
What a nice hit. Just lay the ball right in. Keep the red out of the zone.
Yes, perfect. They have a nice tempo in their playing style. I probably use more time. They can play very uncomplicated. It's very nice to see also for me. I try to complicate things sometimes.
Looks like very good ball speed. The red is pushed over to the corner. It's on the 5.
Now he has a problem. If he can, he can see the red ball. So that's very good.
It's very nice the way the red ball was pushed and banked into the corner for the next shot.
What is very important is the speed, because to make that point it's not so difficult, but
he's holding his head. It looks like it may be bad news, and there's no news. It's a miss.
I think he's very disappointed missing this position. And Semih can play position. Long rail, short rail. Yes, the right of the yellow ball along the rail. It can be another run. I think he has no choice. He must play from the yellow. Yes. And you just
Yes, sir, he made that one.
Yeah.
Not a good start, but the finish was okay.
He must say thank you now for making this point. He hit it much too thick. And I think he can play a wonderful shot now, thin from the red. He can leave the red ball in the corner, just play soft, or he play defensive, so with a fast tempo, with a fast speed. I don't know what he's doing. Very slow. And you see, you take the risk. You play very slow. You missed the point, but this is not easy because the red is not lying very comfortably. Okay, if you have a, of course you have more guarantee for safety if you play harder, but you always have to make difficult positions and you must try to take those risks.
Would you have played the shot three rails like that, or would you have gone twice around?
I think twice around, yes.
Twice around?
Yes.
A better position also, I would imagine.
Well, the main problem is that the red ball was not lying in the corner, but almost frozen at the at the cushion. And that's a big problem, because you can shoot to the corner, but mostly goes in the corner, into the corner. But I would play double round, twice round.
Twice around.
Yes. But okay, that's personal. What is he doing with the yellow ball? Maybe behind the hole? In the hole? Yes. Bravo.
Very nice ball speed.
Not so easy. It looks simple. But you have to control your own cue ball. You have to control the second ball very precisely. And those two things can be a little bit how do you say that?
Difficult.
Yeah.
Until you learn how to do it to be able to push that ball.
Can give you a wrong concentration.
Yes.
Also, what is important? What is he doing with the yellow ball? Yes.
Very smooth.
Yeah, such a fantastic stroke. That's. Now he gets the reward. Good position now. And
for some reason he didn't look happy with that hit. Any particular reason? Or?
Maybe a little bit too hard. I try to keep the red ball,
the
second diamond,
yeah.
But not more, because you always get a little bit complicated position. This is okay. I think this is really okay. Yes, it's okay. But a little bit further to the left, it's always difficult. It looks like an obligation to make this point. But it's always carefully, very precisely. That's why I'm very concentrated always. For me, not one position is very easy. Wrong hit, maybe one such a little piece, wrong hit, and it's wrong. You miss.
It's amazing how they know as soon as they hit the ball that they missed, and they're down there leaning and hoping and praying, and it doesn't seem to work for me, and I guess it doesn't work for anybody. You just have to hit it a little bit better.
He didn't play the shot bad. I just missed him such a little.
I think we're in the eighth inning and it's 23-16. Sammy's ahead. But when you look at a shot that was just missed and you say to yourself, oh boy, look at that, man is shooting over two, you wonder,
yes,
what does it take to win a game if you can't win or have the lead when you're averaging two or better? But today, two doesn't cut it anymore. That was a nice hit. Just past that yellow ball, and
nice tempo,
rolling to the corner.
He's playing very good, I think.
Got a little extra hit on the red, but what do you think of this shot?
Well, he probably would make a draw shot from the red with a good speed and playing five reels, not three reels. Long shot, long. I think it's too much. You have to do too much to make it. Ah, I'm wrong.
Up and maybe down, this is twice around.
Yes. No. I think it's short.
Short.
Yes. Four. No.
Hit the wrong. No. Well, I guess that's the way he played it.
Yeah, it was also a possibility. Two times short cushion, short rail. It gives him a little bit extra possibilities, two chances. Maybe I think he played a little bit too quick on this shot. It's very precise. I mean,
I think it's his style. He gets up, he looks at the table, and he just pulls the trigger and lets it go.
Yeah.
And,
yes, and he just see what happens.
Shot like this, it looks simple from where I'm sitting, and yet he's taking his time, and you wonder, is he thinking about the next shot, or is he actually thinking about this shot?
No, I think it's a draw shot, and I think he would know it in the beginning also, that this is the normal shot to play. He brings the right ball, but the draw shot always means extra feeling, always. If you try to make a draw shot, you must use your feeling extra. If you just shoot, if you just can shoot the ball, you know the lines a little bit, but with a draw shot, you have to do something extra. Very experienced guys, both hands, and a very good chance they will take it with both hands. Ah, but it's a little bit typically sangly.
You don't see many people playing this type of shot.
Bravo. And very softly. That's what it makes more difficult. If you play the shot with a lot of speed, it makes it more simple. Okay, no defensive. It's not defensive, so. It was a beautiful point, but a good position now.
A little bit of a kiss here, and still may be alive. Throwing Sammy a kiss.
I would play from the red because the red ball was so close. To hit on a big distance, it's always a problem. With a lot of English, you make it very hard for yourself. Very thin, but the right ball is, yes. Bravo.
Makes it look so easy.
Yes, it looks very easy sometimes, but this was not easy. You had to draw a little bit, just a little bit too much, and you miss. Tries round the table.
Has to pass the white ball in the front. There it goes, passed it in the front, dead in the red. No kiss. Ball's coming around. And it is perfect.
Very nice, Pete.
It's now on a five. So his average is starting to go up.
Now he has a big problem. He draw, but
I think he'll have to send the white ball back and forth. Push it through the hole. Okay, he pushed it through the hole. And problem. He got it perfect. He's now on an eight.
And now he has a perfect position to play position. Play from the red and put the red ball in the corner. Very softly to the right. And then okay, how do you hit the right ball? It's very important.
I guess he must have been listening to you. He should have hit it the way you said.
Bravo.
To hit it.
Yes.
Perfect hit.
The perfect hit. They're playing wonderful.
Now this type of shot, is this three rails or five rails off the white?
Well, I think I would just play the shot in the corner.
Okay, so you don't really have it in your mind that it's three or five. You just try to. Oh, let's see if this ball gets back together. No chance.
9 points. You see?
9 points.
9 points, yeah. Well, you must be a little bit happy when your opponent misses that kind of shot.
I guess as they say, every shot makes somebody happy.
Bravo.
Okay, it's 25-24.
As far as I can see, they are in very good shape. They play wonderful. They make many beautiful shots.
Ah, that's a bad miss. Yeah.
And if they miss, it's just very, very close.
26-24. Oh no, 25 up. I think it's about 10 innings right now.
Yeah.
So they're both averaging 2.5. Nothing shabby about that.
I mean, if you play many games on these tables, your confidence is always growing. And then you feel what you can do. So I expect good games tomorrow.
Boy, the way he hits that ball and it bites the first rail and kicks and twists and turns. It almost looks like an artistic shot as it's just running down there on radar to get to the object ball. I think he beats his many opponents with great shots as well as with scaring them to death with the way he's able to cue the ball. Seems to have the flow, but this one seems to have gotten away. Looks like Sammy has a little bit of trouble here. I don't even think he could do one of his trick shots.
Maybe thin from the yellow and a lot of speed.
Maybe
go back. I think
long
maybe
long rail, yellow, short rail, long rail, or
Well, I think. I think you can only play from the yellow. Maybe bank shot. Bank shot long rail, short
rail. Okay,
yes.
Two rails behind.
Ah, no, he would play, I think.
Or maybe
long rail from the red,
yes. The way Sang Lee plays it from the back. Oh, what a shot. Uh-huh. What a shot.
They make a fantastic shot.
I think they're making those shots just to prove me wrong that I said there wasn't a high percentage of shooting that shot. And so far we've seen about three of them and two of them were made.
Now he must play from the yellow. Thin. The yellow goes to the corner. To stay with the red. Yeah. High, must play left-handed.
He pushed the yellow into good position and I think he played it from the back and he had a chance of making it from the
back. I think he doesn't like to play this kind of solutions.
Yeah.
He likes to use more power, yeah. More.
He likes to get his money he's worth out of every shot,
yeah.
Mileage, distance. If there would be a Babe Ruth of billiards, we'd have to make it Sammy. What a shot.
Bravo.
I guess anybody could make that shot on three rails. Four rails is the nice hard part about it.
Well, they make incredible shots.
Unbelievable.
And a nice position now, so.
I mean, this is a good angle. We could see Sang with his backhand, he just cinches the ball. You know, sometimes when I watch the better players, I used to think that they were lucky that the balls always landed, that they had nice shots, and as time went on, you began to realize that it wasn't by accident, it was on purpose. Very careless mistake. You could tell that shot wasn't going to make. Sammy was already out of his chair and up there to survey the situation.
Well, if that shot when he that he missed, the second ball was also coming. I always think about the second ball. I don't think too much about my own about making the point, but I always think what will second ball. And so I'm afraid and I try to go as thin as possible. As Sang Lee, just play thick, just because that's safe to make the point. And you see that the second ball was coming too much.
I think that's how you could really tell a good player by what ball he watches. He doesn't watch his own ball, he watches his position ball. And it's probably more important. This is a nice hit. Let's see if it comes up there, which it did. Very good ball speed, good control.
Yeah. But an incredible position now. I think he just play quietly.
Ball came off the rail, really nice.
Bravo.
Right on the money.
Bravo.
That's his type of shot. He just gets up there and strokes the ball. He hits it. And as soon as he hits it, that ball's on radar. Where's he going to shoot the yellow? To the long rail or the short rail?
Long.
Yes. Okay, to the long rail. Comes around the table.
Yeah, but he played a little bit soft. I thought he would play a little bit harder. Because
yeah,
then the yellow ball is coming inside, coming to the middle of the table. So, but I was a little bit afraid that the English would not be 100%. But this is nice. Very thin. That the red ball stays on the long rail. Or maybe... No. That's all.
Chose three rails instead of four.
Yeah, maybe that was better. That was better. Yes. It was just a normal shot to play. I think the red ball is a little bit too close to the cushion. That's why he's looking a little bit. Yes, yeah, a little bit too close. So maybe bank shot. Oh, I don't know what he's doing, but maybe very thin.
I think he'll go around the red.
Oh.
Wow, he sure did go around the red.
I
didn't see what he did there, but it didn't look too good to me from over here. I don't know if he was trying to double a rail or rail first and then the ball.
I think he hit it too hard. The reaction of the two balls were a little bit, maybe, just too much. Okay, he's allowed to miss. He already makes so many nice, beautiful points. You forgive him.
I think he'll have to forgive himself.
Yeah, to the red, and I hate this kinds of shots.
I don't even know what I'm looking at anymore.
Chance of making the shot is so little.
And what would you do? Shoot off the white pin? Just try to.
I try to do something else. I don't like that solution. But it's typically personally for me.
Yeah.
You don't see me often make the shot. I see too many problems. But okay, it doesn't leave a very good position.
Shot he may make it, but for some reason the hit just didn't sound right to me. But
probably
he sure did hit it good. Sort of had a thump to it, but it came around and stayed true.
Maybe thin, yeah. He leaves the red ball as far as possible. Yes.
That red ball looks like it has glue on it the way it's moving.
He's such an attractive player to watch. For me, it's the greatest talent in the world.
Oh yeah.
Absolutely. I also learned a lot from him. To do something with your stroke, with fantasy.
Now, he's pointing and touching both sides of the table. What does that mean to you?
I don't understand.
Well, neither do I. I figured I'd let you explain it.
Carom.
Maybe he has a lot of confidence.
Maybe he was blessing the table and it worked because he should get that point.
Maybe it helps him when I give him, when I give comments to his game. Very good defense, very good defensive.
What happened on that shot that he missed it
maybe
so
he was late? Maybe he was a little bit afraid of the reaction of the second ball that is coming too much, was coming back too much. So I think he tried to control. He was a little bit afraid of doing too much.
If he hit less ball, was there a bigger chance of a kiss?
No, there was no kiss. There was no kiss, but when he did a little bit too much, when he's doing a little bit too much, it would be always be in a corner. So it's a little bit the wrong reaction of your arm. When you're just afraid of doing too much, so you save your stroke a little bit and you do too little.
What do we have here? Wow.
Very, very interesting. Yeah. What he was doing.
Could have been a crowd pleaser if he made that one.
But very smart played, because it's easy to play this shot. It's just you shoot very hard in the cushion. You know that the ball is coming shorter. And you have a chance that you can make it.
Yes.
A very nice solution.
Is he going to just drop it in here?
Yeah. Also one of my favorite shots. That's very nice.
Yeah.
So
a little trouble.
Yeah,
like
a little bit. Yeah. That's so easy. That's so easy. He's trying to control the game now. Play good defensive.
We're at 14 innings, and the score is 29-35 in favor of Semih Sayginer. So 14 innings. Both averaging over two, and I'm running out of my fingers and toes. I won't be able to keep up the averages in my head very longer.
And especially Sang Lee gets a difficult shot at this moment, a really difficult shot. So you can't say he's playing bad, he's playing wonderful. But what can you do with these kinds of shots?
Oh!
And you see what happens?
Controlled the ball the last two, three innings, and it's paid off now. Seems to not only have made the point, I think he feels very confident. Seems to have that good feeling about him. Looks like he's light on his toes. Well, let's see if he gets the bonus. Okay, 15 innings are finished. The score is 29, 32. I can't see the other number. 30 what? What's the score? 36.
Okay.
Had a little help from Ira Lee. Has a better seat since I'm new at commentary. I had to sit behind the pole. Wow. Oh, that could have been bad news.
Yeah. A little bit too soft.
He made the point, but he's not very happy.
A little bit too soft.
Too soft.
I think so, yes. There was not so much reaction anymore from the short rail.
It's amazing how you come in, get a full hit, you get a hang here, you get a little soft hit, and you wind up with a more difficult shot. Oh, what a nice little hit. But looks like he's leaving the table.
Yeah.
Yeah, us beginners, we stand there and say our prayers, hoping the ball's going to change its mind and listen to us and make a U-turn and come and hit the other ball for us. And we've been doing that for years and nothing's happened, but we're still going to continue to do it. It seems to make us feel better. Yes, it's called body English.
Bravo.
Yeah, Sammy's hitting that ball really nice.
Everything in the middle of the table. It seems like it's a simple shot, but we miss it many times also.
What is it, a little feather hit? Oh, look at this. Let the good times roll.
He can play five rails. It looks much more simple, but maybe
I think
he tried to use his fantasy.
No.
I don't know.
I think we scared
maybe
him.
Maybe it's
there it comes. It's still coming. And it's...
Oh, bravo.
It's arrived.
Yeah.
I guess we call that shot 3, 5, or 7 rails.
The quality is fantastic, what he's doing.
Oh, you could say he Sperberized it. He hit that good, but to look at him standing at the table, you wonder. He wasn't happy, so you wonder, what was he looking for? Better position, or...?
Well, the position is perfect.
Yeah, that's what I feel.
It's perfect.
It's as good as you're going to get.
Yeah.
Yeah, he seems to have the confidence in his stroke right now. I think we're about the 16th inning now.
Ah.
Yeah. Yep.
It's 40-30 for Sayginer.
16 innings.
But Sayginer has an opportunity now. It's so easy to make a mistake on these kinds of positions. You do a little bit too much. Always have to need a good concentration also on these positions. I think he must play from the right, but Babu Singh.
Nice shot, perfect position. He's now 32 points. He's on a two in the 16th inning, so his average is back up to two. And he's losing by 8 points. If I averaged two and lost the game, I think I would have to consider another sport, maybe ping pong.
Ooh.
This is an expensive miss.
It's so easy to make a mistake in this kind of positions, and you see what happens.
Oh, I think he was careless. I don't think he really stroked it enough. He usually strokes and strokes, and this time, for some reason, I think all the shots out of that particular corner he's been a little afraid of for some reason.
You know, if you make that shot, you have another good shot. And that means it can be a high run. And look what happens. Another good shot, another good position. And after this, probably another good solution. So I think at least he has 3 points now, almost.
Well, this is the shot that he missed on Kuhlman today. He had a little three-rail shot that was a lot easier than this one. And
it looks like he's playing. Why he's doing
I don't believe it. He missed it again.
I thought that he could play thin on the second ball and just leave the second ball very close to the long rail, and yes, but okay, maybe he has a better side on the table than we have. It looks very simple.
Well, I think Sang's going to take advantage here now. I think he feels up to it right now. That's the second time I saw Sammy miss that three-rail short shot today. I don't think these balls are so, I guess. What do you think? What's the story here now with the shot? Off the red, four rails?
Yes, four rails, yes, from the red, yeah. You can avoid the kiss easily. It looks difficult here, but I think there was no kiss at all. Yeah.
You could see the stroke was very comfortable, a nice little punch. The red ball goes back into the corner. So.
But this is not so nice.
The red ball didn't go far enough.
He's also thinking, I make the point, but
just drop it in, long rail, long rail. Oh, he's looking at something here. I always wonder when people go up and they stroke the ball and they look at it that way, what there is that's going to happen. What shot would you play here?
Maybe thin, twice around the table. Thin.
Twice around.
Yes, I like these shots. I like to go thin on the ball, but I think he must do it because.
See, I think when he was stroking the red before, he might have been looking off the red, short rail, long rail, long rail. But I think he's going to drop it in.
Thick,
sort of his style
the,
shot.
Thick on the right ball. That's right ball is away.
I think the white is safe. Yeah, there it goes.
Ah, it's playing softly.
Yeah, very bad hit. But what do I know?
Bravo.
Perfect hit. Yeah, I guess he made a liar out of me on that one.
If you play the shot hard, it's more simple. But if you miss, you don't play defensive.
You give up the family jewels.
They use nice expressions, Don.
Well, when you bring them back to Europe, leave my name out of it.
But yeah, you see, he's a little bit too soft on the red ball, and he has no opening, so this is a really problem.
I don't know, I seem to think he'll drop it in on the front of, I think he's going to draw the ball, go past the white, and then have it pick up speed on the second and third rail.
Yeah.
Well, maybe he should ask Sammy to help him with it. Sammy likes to play these with a little bit of a stroke, and a little flair. And he's taking his time. He's picking out his little spot on the rail. I think he's got a good chance of making this. I think it's almost like a straight rail shot. Just got to get past the white ball. Oh, something different now. Looks like a back and forth four railer.
Yeah.
A little Blomdahl drop in, bounce out, but not enough speed.
Yeah. I think everybody is scared to play these shots. What is the reaction on the third cushion? Third rail is always guessing.
What's the score now? I can't see.
41-36 for Semih.
Okay.
So it's only 5 points away.
I think it's 18 innings. Well, you got to have nerves of steel to get up and hit that ball and just know you're going to make it.
Take on the yellow, a lot of English. Or maybe just he's going through the ball. Just let him drop.
Nice shot.
Yeah. Ah, that's a nice kiss. That's a nice kiss. Otherwise it would be a very complicated defensive shot. Now through this kiss, it's a fantastic possibility to make the point. And she is playing from the red because otherwise he has to draw, has to make a draw shot from the yellow. But maybe he's changing.
Is it? Well, if you did play it off the red, is it three rails or five rails?
I would play it five rail.
Five rails.
Maybe three rail because I have to take care of the kiss.
It lines up in the corner or not. Yeah. Okay, five rails. He whipped it and he still got away with it. Okay, that's a three. It's late at night now, and I guess this is the fifth game or the sixth game of the day, and even the crowd is a little under the weather. You don't hear them applauding and cheering, and they just don't have the energy left, but they're diehard billiard players. They're just sitting there looking around the room and watching, hoping everybody has big runs so they can go home and go to sleep.
It's a little bit too tough to play five games in a row.
Yeah.
It's very hard.
That was a very nice shot.
Bravo. And the chance of making this point is very big. I can't imagine he would play from the yellow.
Yeah. Well, this is his type of shot. Nice stroke, draw back. It's amazing with his drawback shots. It's a terrible shame to miss
that. Suppose he would make the shot. Yeah. I think it would be the victory, almost be the victory of this game. But now, it can always change.
Yeah. Now you see Sammy draw back on that. It doesn't matter if he hits it hard or he hits it soft. He still goes twice around the table with no trouble at all. Hey, is this shot twice around or just thin hit right in?
No, twice, I think.
Twice around, yeah. Is it twice around because it's easier or twice around for the position?
To make the point.
Just to make the point. Okay, look at this. Well, his ball...
Maybe he's coming... No.
Say, at the end of the game, the balls just don't roll as far. Very big mistake.
Well, Sammy looks like he's a little bit angry, but he's really playing well. I mean, okay, you all make unnecessary mistakes, but I think he's playing a wonderful game.
Well, they both made a lot of good shots, but they've also missed a lot of easy ones. So.
Very nice hit.
What's the score now?
46-37 for Sayginer.
46-37.
4 points left.
Could be a bad news.
Well, I know Sengli likes these shots, but
he just doesn't like that corner. Every time he's had a ball down in that corner, he's taking a little extra time, so I don't know what's doing down there, but it's not his favorite corner, nor not his favorite part of town.
He's afraid for something, so he's... He's playing a difficult bank shot now.
No, I think he's going to play long rail, red ball, two rails, and back to the white.
You're right there, though.
Sometimes when they go and they... Yeah.
But he has to play very hard now.
No, I don't think so. I think he'll just... I think he's going to finesse it. But I can never figure out when they touch the diamonds, 3-4 diamonds away, if they... have some kind of parallel system or some kind of
I think it's just feeling. I think he loves to play these shots, and it's a lot of feeling, and we have all kinds of shots we like to play.
Okay, now I know what he was looking at. He was looking at a bank, long rail, short rail, long rail, and he feels that spot up around the second diamond gives him a big ball. He just has to hit the first ball, and he didn't.
You see what happens?
Yeah.
Very good position.
I think he made a poor choice. Well, I think he's thinking about just getting one more chance up at the table, and he'd be satisfied with that.
He's a little bit out of the line, so Semih is doubting, what shall I do? When this yellow ball is a little bit more left, it would be absolute no problem, but I think there was a very big kiss. But I think you must play the shot. You have no choice almost.
How would you cue the ball? A little reverse, center ball, or what would the hit be?
Maybe... Ah, just...
Oh. Hey, that one got away. Yeah. It's 37 Sang Lee, 47 Semih Sayginer. 20 innings. 20 innings, they're shooting great and they're missing shots, so you wonder, what's this game really all about? He's gonna try maybe a...
Behind the red ball,
double around. Usually hits these balls pretty good, but gets to the end of the game and you really need it. I guess it becomes a little tougher. And the referee is getting ready to make his call.
And bravo.
Makes it look so easy.
Bravo, thank you. He's absolutely a champion in these shots.
Yeah, he's incredible on those one rail and two rail tickies. Well, he needed 13. Let's see if he could do it. Somehow, I got the feeling he's going to do it here. All he needs is the balls to stay out in the open and not hide. A nice back and forth shot.
Maybe two times long, yeah.
Uh-oh. Oh. Little help? No help. Yeah. Looks like the fat lady's getting ready to sing. Gets back to the table again.
But incredible positions.
I think Sang needs 11 and Sangna needs 2.
Yes, right. But Semih was smart to do this. No risk.
Here comes Rusty.
Bravo.
What a nice shot. I don't think the position is so nice here. Could have been better.
Well, it's, I think it's possible, but very precisely.
What other choices does he have here?
Well, normally long, short, long rail. Maybe, yeah, I think it's, you must do this.
Well, it looks like the white ball is going to stay maybe a diamond or two down, so he's really got to make this. I think he's got it.
Yes.
By golly, he's got it. Well, the crowd seems to have woken up. They're clapping their hands together. They may be doing it just to stay awake, or they sense the end of the game is coming.
Now, very thin. The red ball is also coming to the third ball, so yeah. That's a big risk if you do play like this. It's a big risk.
Well, I think he's just shooting out the wind now. I don't think he, I think he knows this is his last chance to dance, so he's going to be out there dancing.
Maybe he can play from the right to play a little bit defensive. I would.
Wow. I guess the crowd just woke up.
But a terrible position.
Yeah,
not so lucky. Not so lucky with this.
Yeah, but I think back and forth, 50-50 chance.
I would maybe prefer to play long, long, long rail.
I think he listens to you, not to me. Oh, up and down. Oh, boy.
Could have been very close.
Yeah. I think he must have had it if he was disappointed in the kiss. Because usually when he shoots, as soon as he hits the ball, if it's not on, he's in the chair.
Yeah.
He doesn't hang around for donuts and coffee. Speaking of food, I think I'm getting hungry again. I got to plan my next meal. It's been at least an hour or two. This muffin just didn't cut it for me.
Semih's a little bit afraid for this shot, I think, but
I think
he has to play from the yellow.
Up the long way. Nope, down the short way. He just hasn't been doing good in that end of the table on them short shots.
Yeah. It's a little bit remarkable that he missed his shot.
It's a very interesting bridge he has off the rail. I can never figure out how to do that. Oh my goodness. If Sang loses this game in order to stay alive, he needs other people to lose a couple of games in order for him to be back in the ball game. Oh my goodness.
What's happening?
Boy, oh boy.
Something is happening with Semih.
We're going to have to check the innings and the average and like to replay the tape and see if this really happened these last two, three innings. It's a good thing the crowd doesn't have any vegetables. They may start to throw it at us. Uh, Nice, Sang has enough chalk on his hand, he can paint the walls. Okay, here goes them back and forth. 3, 5, or 7.
Three rails, I think.
Yeah.
Yes, bravo.
There we are. Coming alive.
It's the exciting end of the game.
42 plus one for this inning is 43 to 48. How many innings is it? Well, if we can't get the scorekeeper to tell us the innings. 23 innings, we're just guessing now. This could be the shot to break things wide open. This little woofy stroke off the ball. Looks like he woofed it. He's still there. Little kiss developing, no kiss.
Bravo.
Center. That makes it now 44-48. Almost the same shot as before.
Yeah.
Maybe this one a little easier. Oh, almost brought that white out of the neighborhood. Well, what do we have here?
I think he played bank shot with the righty. Ah, no, he's playing.
Oh. Very tough.
Maybe I would play long rail, short long. Okay, also.
Reverse the rails?
Yeah.
Very tough to reverse the rails here, but he's going to do it. Oh, beautiful. Oh. So that's 4. That puts him up to 46 to 48. He only needs 4. And I think this back and forth is his style. Give it perfect. Yeah. That's 5. 47-48. He needs the red to bounce a little, so he has a little more room.
Incredible position now.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't like this position at all. Unless you have some recommendations for him, maybe we could sell it to him.
I think he must take care of his defense.
Twice now.
I think so, and yeah.
Well, it's amazing. Yes. If the red would have stopped out in the open, up another 4 or 5 inches, be in much better shape. Oh boy. Oh boy.
He's trying to play.
Oh boy. Yeah, I'd like to see him play the white, short rail, long rail, short rail.
Yeah, from the right and maybe a little bit artistic.
Yeah. Oh. He certainly went for the gusto. I didn't think he had enough speed off the first ball to get the action that he needed.
Yeah, it's very difficult. What he was trying to do.
It's not good sitting in the chair right now. is number 49 coming up. Oh, this could be a little short.
I think it's good.
Yeah, I think so. He didn't flinch. What inning are we in? This is the 24th inning. Oh, 49. What's the score there?
49 to 47.
47 for Sang getting up to shoot. He needs three. Most interesting.
Maybe he should have taken the risk to make the point. He made it very difficult for himself, playing on such a big distance at the second ball.
He would have played off the red?
I think so, yes. I think so. Better
off the red, okay. Just to score.
Yes, I think so. Yeah. I think so.
Well, I don't know what he's doing here, but...
Also, Sang Lee can make wonderful shots.
I don't know if he's going to play rail first to the red or maybe just twice around. Looks like he's shooting rail first off the red. Looks like the crowd's getting their money's worth now. Look at that. Well, I think he's okay here. He has many shots. What's your favorite here?
Well, I think he must go right on the red. Just two chances. Yes, I think he will do it. Yeah. Just hit, try to play good in the corner.
Yeah.
Left under. Yeah. On the left.
You don't like it off the left side of the red, three rails?
Well, if you miss, you always leave a very good position.
Yeah. I don't think.
But you can see the third ball better.
Yeah.
If you play this shot, you can see the third ball. Yeah. You feel maybe more.
Yeah, I didn't think he liked it off the right. You know, we're sitting. We can't really see the angle. But this is a very important shot. Oh, look at this! He went for twice around. Push the red into the corner. He's coming up on the ball. He's on his toes. And he made the shot. Well, when he went up on his toes, it was sort of a signal of bad news for the fans, but
he
might have just been looking for the position.
He's a little bit unlucky, really unlucky.
I think he'll hit this ball thin and go around the white. This is the 25th inning, so he'll have an average of two. And maybe he's going to draw back. Can't go around the ball. It's one of his best shots. He's coming around. He's going in the hole. And he got it. Wow, what a game.
Okay.
Hallelujah.
That game took 25 innings.
All I can tell you is one player has his teeth showing. Okay.
Oh, what a narrow escape. But he did it on his own.
Listen, I want to know how Sammy's going to sleep tonight after this game. Oh, who knows? Maybe Sang will be buying the coffee. Okay, we're signing off. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye.
Well, thank you, Don Sperber, for sitting in with Dick Jaspers. That was a very, very exciting match. Dick, I want to thank you for doing the commentary. It's been wonderful. I'm sure it was... he just gestured. He hoped his English was fine. I'm sure his English was great. This is Jan Call for Carom TV. Hoping you enjoyed that match, and we look forward to doing it again. But this, it's late on a Saturday night, and till the next time. Signing off.
To the red, long cushion, short cushion, long cushion, short cushion, long cushion, long cushion, short cushion, long cushion. I get tired.